Welcome to your Daily Writing Habit, episode number 204. If you are writing a book or thinking about it, or maybe you've started writing your book and you need some help getting it done, or maybe you need help reaching more readers to tell them about your book, you are in the right place. I'm your host, Christine Whitmarsh, also known as Christine Inc., I-N-K, christine-inc.com. Each day, I'm sharing with you the writing habits I've learned over my 18 years as a ghostwriter, book coach, and author. I have found that three things in particular have a huge impact on your success as an author, and they have the ability to turn someone who doesn't really see themselves as an author into one. Those three things are writing fundamentals, productivity, and mindset habits. Here's today's quote. Maybe this is why we read, and why in moments of darkness we return to books, to find words for what we already know. Alberto Manguel. It is FAQs Friday, frequently asked question day, where I answer the questions that you guys are all asking me online mainly, whether the questions are about the hats I wear as a ghostwriter, book coach, or author, or about writing habits, productivity, all the other writing-related questions on your mind. I love answering them. Today's question comes from one of the members of my Inc. Authors group on Facebook, and she asks, how long does it take after writing a book to read another book without an editing hat? Ever? I know this particular author, she finished her book, so she's probably been reading it and doing so many rounds of editing. I totally get this. Well, the good news and the bad news is the answer is forever. And this is bad news, I guess, if you look at change as a bad thing, if you look at change and evolution as a bad thing. Because as an author, having gone through the development, writing, and editing process for your own book, you've now created new neural pathways in your brain around reading, or you've begun to even. In other words, you've taught yourself how to read differently, how to read with a purpose, to look for errors and ways to improve on the writing. Now, the good news about this is, because I know what you're thinking, like, how can I enjoy a book if I'm editing it? It's not really editing it. I tried to describe this in a few other episodes too. It's more like you're reading analytically as an author. But for me, it doesn't take away my enjoyment of the book. It actually enhances it. So let me explain. So the good news is, unless you're in the habit of reading poor quality books with a ton of typos, you've now actually deepened the reading experience for yourself. By writing a book yourself, you have, in a sense, pulled the curtain back and discovered the Wizard of Oz behind it. You know how writing works now. So rather than being a passive observer, you can be an active participant in the story. This helps you enjoy books on a whole new level because you'll have better insights into why they're so good. And yes, this is true. Your tolerance for mediocre and bad books will lessen dramatically over time. But really think about it. How much time in your life did you want to waste in reading bad books? You're now seeing life through a writer's eyes, which for me is a much richer, more enjoyable reading experience. So I hope that answers your question. And be sure and drop by my Inc. Authors group. It exists now on Facebook and LinkedIn. So whether you prefer Facebook or LinkedIn, look for Inc. Authors, I-N-K, and then authors. Submit your questions about and let me know. This is an FAQs Friday question, so I know it's for a future episode. And you'll hear your question answered over one of the next few Fridays. Thank you for joining me here on Your Daily Writing Habit, where I'm helping you write and finish writing an awesome book. And like I said, be sure and drop by Inc. Authors on Facebook or LinkedIn for motivation, accountability, book writing, publishing, resources, and more. And if you know someone else who wants to write an awesome book, please let them know about Your Daily Writing Habit. Thank you, and until tomorrow, happy writing.